Do you know why the area of rectangle is length times its breadth and why these other basic formulas always work? In this video, we will discuss some basic concepts about area. You are watching Brain Explorers, the world where brain starts working. Before discussion of area, take a look of measurement. What is measurement? Measurement of something unknown is nothing but its comparison with something known. For example, if you are asked to draw a line of 10 cm without using a ruler, then you can draw a line whose length is close to 10 cm. This is because you have an idea of 1 cm. You know how much is 1 cm and you try to draw 10 times of it. But if I ask you to produce a magnetic field of 10 Tesla, you can't do so if you have no idea of 1 Tesla. But if you know how much is 1 Tesla, then you can try to produce 10 Tesla also. The quantity which you are using as something standard to compare is called unit of that quantity. We must have a unit to compare with it the areas which we have to measure. And that unit is I square. I square having unit side length like centimeter, meter, kilometer, etc. If there is a rectangle of length 4 cm and width 2 cm, then its area is the number of unit squares contained in it times the area of 1 unit square. It contains 8 such squares and therefore its area is 8 square centimeters. Similarly, a rectangle of length L and width B contains L times B unit squares, thus its area is considered as L times B. Area of some basic shapes like triangle, trapezium, and circle can also be calculated with the help of rectangle. Suppose a triangle of height H and base B is placed inside a rectangle of side B and H. Altitude of the triangle divides it into right angle triangles. If inverted duplicates of these triangles are also placed inside the rectangle, then it is completely filled, which means its area is double of the triangle. Hence, the area of triangle is half of rectangle. If instead of height and base, all three sides are given, then the area of triangle can be calculated by Heron's formula. To derive this formula, let's first calculate the height of this triangle. Apply the Pythagoras in the two right angle triangles formed due to its altitude. We get h square equals to a square minus x square equals to c square minus b minus x whole square. On solving this, we have x is equal to a square plus b square minus c square over 2b. With its help, h can also be calculated. Now we have height as well as base. Put these values in the formula half base times height, and after some simplifications, we get the area of triangle in terms of A, B, and C. Come to the parallelogram. You can cut a triangle from one side, invert it, and place on another side to form rectangle, or you can just cut the parallelogram into thin slices and put all these over one another to form the rectangle. Area of trapezium can also be calculated in many ways. Here we have shown by dividing it in rectangle and triangles. Circle seems a bit difficult because it doesn't have sides and it is a little tricky to compare it with rectangle or square. Assume that circle is formed by many tiny sectors. Take these sectors one by one and place side by side in alternate opposite directions. If there are infinite number of sectors, then the new shape formed is a rectangle. Circumference is forming the two equal sides of rectangle, therefore length of each side is half of circumference. And width of rectangle is equal to radius, so area of rectangle becomes pi r square. With the help of same logic, area of sector can also be calculated. Don't forget to like and share our video, and for more such videos, subscribe to our channel Brain Explorers. Thanks for watching.